Charles Davis ready for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup as you get a peek at some of the big players in today's game, and you're a big player in today's game as well. Let's get the party started. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This fielded at the two. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out. To the 25-yard line. Now the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Again, it's Elliott. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains.
Second and one, if people want to run the football, this is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the first down.
First down carry by Elliott. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a second and 3. 3 yards remaining here on second down.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
It's Hill, complete. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't
they? When we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time. Really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
And he's going to get this one down right to the edge of the red zone to the chalk of the 20.
That was a nice completion on an out route, and those types of plays are the result of arm strength by the quarterback and timing by the receiver.
Now back to the ground with Elliott, and he'll get this one down to about the 17. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
And Boyd has it over the middle. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
They'll try and run for it with Elliott. And he's going to be taken down right at the line. And it appears they'll go for it here on fourth down. A big call on the game's opening drive. Running with Elliott. Ezekiel Elliott not able to get it past the marker. And on the opening drive of the afternoon, the defense forces a turnover on downs. They'll start the drive with Elliott. And this defense feeling the encouragement. They stop him at the line of scrimmage on the first play of the afternoon. That's going to go as a loss of 1 yard, and it'll be second down. Now Breeze throwing on second down. He's got the hook up to Odell Beckham. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route. and then breaks it up, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
Back with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. It's Mexico City football to begin quarter number two, but they face a second and long to start things out. Second down, here's Breeze. Now Breeze lost the football. And this is recovered in the end zone by the defense. My goodness, what a late turn of events here. Once that ball was loose, the question was, would this be two or would it be six? It's six, the defense able to pounce on it.
And for the offense, the training didn't really kick in, did it? Once that ball comes loose, you've got to get on it, make sure that you recover it, or make sure you punch it out of the end zone. Anything but give it to the defense to score a touchdown.
And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Now this offense ready to take over again. Play fake here on first down. Rolling to his left. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
It's not like pressure to affect the accuracy and the timing of a guy trying to throw the football. And on that play, they ended up flushing him to his left, contacted him as he's trying to throw the football, and that led to the incompletion.
Breeze again here on second and 10. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Now Breeze on third down. Over the middle to Beckham. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth. So the offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on fourth and three.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this go around?
I don't think it changes much for the head coach, because this is what he preaches all the time. Attack at all times in any spot in the field. And he likes touchdowns, not field goals. Now, your field goal kicker, you've got to make sure you nurse him through and say, okay, don't worry about it. When we need you, you've got to be ready to go. And the team, of course, loves to see points on the board. So let's see if it changes a little bit if they're in the same spot again.
Yeah, we'll see what the decision is here if they get to that spot. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. It's a loss of two. Now third down.
But Nick Fairley's on his game. He is your prototypical defensive tackle who can make disruptive plays. Great hands, really good quickness.
On play action, it's Breeze. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And they're able to convert on third with a solid gain of 23. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
They'll try again with Elliott. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. Back to more NFL action on EA Sports after this. Breeze now on third and goal. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Deion Buchanan. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Now this offense ready to head back out there. And this offense last time turned it over, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to give a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good, but when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that'll loosen up things a little bit, won't it? Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
He's going to try and throw on third down. Escaping the pressure right. And that's caught by Beasley. And they get 14 yards there and a first down.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Fletcher Cox. Coming up the middle, gets him there for a loss of about nine. Now Breeze throwing on second down. He'll rifle this one deep, and that's caught inside the 35. A gain of 39 that time.
Not the tallest receiver on the field, but he just shouted to Mitt that the little guy can't go downfield and make a big-time catch on a deep pass, because sometimes they just out-scrap you for the football.
And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. 10 yards still left on second down.
A lot of teams love to throw screen passes. They want to tire out defenses because they make them run a lot. But there are a lot of moving parts on a play-for-an offense when they call that one. Because you got the linemen that have to move. You got the wide receivers have to get out and vacate. You got the running back that's got to make a little fake and then get out into the route. And of course, the quarterback, he's got to hold in there and know he's probably going to take a big hit before it lofts the screen off to the back. Why didn't he catch it? That's all he needed to do for them to be successful.
Breeze to throw again. He's going to go up top for the end zone. A fight for the football, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Logan Ryan. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Buzz temp.
Now, whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Breeze to throw on second down. Oh, and the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
Now Breeze. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line.
I don't care how many times we see it. I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they...
Now a loose football. The ball comes out. It's going the other way. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. And where the ball is now, you got the field goal pretty much in the bag. Now do you try for the end zone a couple of times?
I don't think there's any question about it. You might get a gift of 6 points rather than the three that you just noted.
Under pressure, and he will go down. Sack back at the 38. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. One man in the backfield, Elliott. To throw is Breeze. On the left side, he finds Beasley. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. A big completion there, and he gets out of bounds to stop the clock.
Very heady football. That allows them the opportunity to go ahead and line up and kick one right before the half ends.
And Boswell's kick is good. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
It's in the game.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. So here they come, the road team now getting the football first to start this third quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. Now Elliott, and he's going to take this one down to about the 23-yard line. A gain of three, second down.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
Give him six on the play, and that'll make it third and one.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Beckham, the lone receiver right. Here's Bree, and he fires one that's intercepted. And I think he's going to go. They're not going to get him. Picked off by Levante David. 20, 10, 5, and they will score. It's a pick six for the Cardinals touchdown. Short throw pick six right there, those linebackers. They love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
And this one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot out as this one's in the air. And now back out comes the offense. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one, that didn't bother you too much, right?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position, not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. Second down following the run.
And once again, leverage wins. The offensive line, lower than the defensive front. They moved him and found some good space for the guy carrying the ball.
8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. He'll get about three as he's brought down right around the 42.
I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up to play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
15 yards through the air and a first down. And they're going to speed things up here. They go play action here on first down. He's got time. This is caught by Antonio Brown. Give him nine there on the first down completion.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Now that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack. After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it. In the end zone, a big-time drop.
Breeze now to throw. And he's got Kyle Rudolph. A pickup of 24 on the third down conversion. Welcome back live to Orlando. As it looks like we are just about set and ready to begin with the fourth. Throwing now is Breeze. And it's caught. Touchdown. Antonio Brown from 4 yards out. Here we go now as we get set for a big two-point conversion. Well, that's about as quick of a passing touchdown as you'll ever see right there.
Everyone has a section in their playbook called the quick game. That was a super quick game. Out of the hands of the thrower, bam, right to the receiver, successfully for a touchdown.
How in-depth is that quick game part of the playbook?
It's pretty in-depth because people want the ball out of the hands of the quarterback into the playmaker's hands downfield as fast as possible. There are a lot of plays, a lot of options involved with that.
Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
Big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Now they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. One man in the backfield, Elliott. He'll get the football here. And he is going to lose yardage here. He lost two there, and it's third down. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up in the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
And he'll go out of bounds across the 35-yard line. 18 yards there and a first down.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or a takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
Give them three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
Tough day. Tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Getting late here in the fourth, and if this team has any chance to win this football game, their defense obviously needs a stop here. So here we go, first and 10 now. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. The give is to Elliott, and he is going to lose yardage here. Now here's a timeout coming on the defensive side of the ball. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. They come up in an offset eye. On second down, Elliott fighting through, fighting him off.
Just ran right through the trash.
As he's got this down inside the 40 to the 39. Now a stoppage here. We'll get another timeout. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number seven on third and two. Breeze to throw. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Partner, how many times have you heard it? Pressure creates diamonds, right? But it also bursts pipes. And on that one, that's what they got. They got after him, and he was fortunate just to get rid of it.
Yeah, he just had to chuck it away. And here's a big one now. Try to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Now Breeze. The Cardinals unable to convert there on fourth down. And as a result, possession switches hands. So out now comes the offense back onto the field. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
Back to throw. And this one caught by Beasley. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at it, and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out, to the sideline, and make a catch.
7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
There's a completion to the tight end, and I think that we're looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
Absolutely. I mean, size, the hands.
Speed. I mean, can flat out run. You put that whole package together, you light up the eyes of an offensive coordinator, don't you?
So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground, and it brings up third.
I'm laughing to myself because I could just hear in film session, but coach, I was throwing to Odell Beckham Jr. Of course I thought he was open.
They'd love to go deep downfield to him, though. Such a threat.
Yeah, a rare incompletion because most of the time we expect him to actually come up with the catch.
Back to throw. He gets it to Brown. Complete. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. And now a first down following that long gain. One man in the backfield, Elliott. He'll look to throw. That's caught at the 2. And now here's a timeout defensively coming from the Cardinals. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. They come out with 1 back and 3 tight ends. They'll try to run it in with Elliott. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the 4th.
Wow. Wow. Did you see them hold up 4 fingers at the start of the 4th quarter?
They were ready.
They were definitely ready. They may or may not have done that, but they certainly have played that way. The 4th quarter has belonged to them, and now the lead belongs to them as well.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. 1 possession game, time very much a factor. How does the offense handle this situation?
Well, in a lot of cases, they should be somewhat relaxed. And I know that's counterintuitive because this is a pressure situation. But this is Friday practice every week of the season. You go over this situation, having to go downfield, limited timeouts, got to get out of bounds and keep the drive going and set yourself up. Defensively, you can't just lay back and let them do whatever they want, so it isn't.
Now Breeze wants the football, and the offense will get this one back. Boy, that could have been catastrophic at this late stage of the game, but they avoid disaster. Easy. And some secondary help here for the defense and the nickel on 3rd and long. Yannick Ngakoue in there to get him his 2nd sack now of the afternoon.
And this offense needs a touchdown. A field goal won't get it done in this situation. But after giving up back-to-back sacks, things are looking a little bit bleak.
Now Breeze got to have this one. He's going to let it. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. There he goes, right side. And he's across for the touchdown. And it's likely the game winner. Stages.
I think it'd be real easy here to focus on maybe a defensive breakdown with that type of a play in this situation. But let's give a little bit of credit here. That type of play is clutch.
Boy, it was clutch, but to turn it back to the defense, how crushing is that? You think you've got this thing won, and in the last moments, almost literally, you lose it.
Snatching defeat from the jaws of victory.
This one taken just inside the 10. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23.